For those of you who don't know, my name's Connor, and today I'm going to be breaking down my budget student desk setup and how I was able to put it together for just over 90 Australian dollars. Yep, you heard that correctly. Everything I've used to put together this setup, other than my laptop, but actually including the seat I'm sitting on right now, cost me a total of $90.49. Now, I don't know about you guys, but for at least the last few months, I've been obsessed with watching desk setup videos. And thanks to most people nowadays actually working from home, there have been so many more videos to consume. But there is one problem. Many of these setups cost tens of thousands of dollars, not to mention all of the free products these YouTubers get so that they can promote them in these videos. And so, as someone who doesn't have thousands of dollars to put towards a desk setup, I set myself a challenge to design myself an aesthetic workspace that wouldn't cost me more than $100. And this is that setup. Now, just before we get into it, if you guys do enjoy videos like these and you'd like me to post more, just quickly go down and pop a like on the video. And hopefully, this will also help the channel grow at the same time. Okay, so now that that's out of the way, let's jump into it. Just a quick warning, I had to use some pretty unorthodox methods to be able to get the setup you see behind me. And so, as a result, some of these items are actually no longer manufactured, but I'll do my best to give good alternatives. So if you so desire, you can try and recreate the setup. To start us off, we'll look at the furniture that makes up this setup. And the first item on the list is actually this chair. Believe it or not, this was actually a curbside pickup, meaning someone had actually thrown this on the side of the road, waiting for the council to come and clean it up. And luckily enough, I drove past at just the right time and picked up a steal. As you can see, the faux leather covering is almost in new condition, but more importantly, the adjustable height mechanism is still working great. Now, what's even crazier than finding a perfect desk chair on the side of the road is finding two. And these two weren't even found at the same spot. About a week after we picked up this one I'm sitting on now, Majella and I were walking back from the movies when we saw this seemingly broken chair on the side of the road. And although it looked a little worse for wear, upon further inspection, all it needed was a few nuts and bolts and a quick cleanup, and we just saved ourselves a few $100. Now, for those of you who aren't as lucky as us and would like an actual retail alternative, IKEA actually stock a couple options that, for the price, are definitely worth looking into. These being the Lobberget, which is priced at $45, and the Renberget, which is priced at $75. And moving on to the desk, we've got another IKEA product, and this is called the MIC. The desktop itself is 142 centimeters by 50 centimeters, and for me, the width is perfect. I like having additional space either side of my keyboard for taking notes and things like that. The only thing I will say is that it is a tiny bit shallow for my liking, but other than that, it does the job perfectly. It also comes with two large drawers, which is perfect for storage and keeping things off the desktop itself. Now, for those of you who are familiar with this desk or have already looked it up, you'll know that in the black brown, it actually costs $169. However, that's definitely not what I paid to get my hands on this desk. Instead, I actually only paid $35 for this. And the way I was able to do that was by using Gumtree. Now, I've done a lot of secondhand selling and purchasing over the last year, and I will say, while Gumtree is still an awesome option, if you are going to be buying or selling anything, I would definitely recommend that you also consider Facebook Marketplace. Another quick tip is, if you're trying to buy any sort of secondhand furniture, IKEA has a great secondary market. So what I would recommend you do, and what I've done for this desk, what I've done for my bookshelves, is look for an item that you're interested in on IKEA's website, get the name, and just type that in when you're searching on Facebook Marketplace or Gumtree. And more often than not, someone will have mentioned the name of the specific item that you are wanting to buy for much lower than market price. Now, in saying that, you're not always going to get perfect products. And as you can see, there's a few blemishes I have on this desk. But also know, if you buy any IKEA product that's missing a couple of bolts or some screws, you can find all of the instruction manuals online for free. And on top of that, you can go to IKEA and get the exact screws, bolts, whatever it may be, entirely for free. So I would 100% recommend doing each of these steps before going in and buying the item full price. And if you don't believe me, this is a makeshift office Majella and I actually put together in 2 days using Facebook Marketplace and Gumtree. The total cost for both the desks and both the chairs was $75. Now, if you couldn't find any deals in the secondary market or the side of the road wasn't producing anything, here's an alternative that again comes from IKEA, but for the price is great value. For just $59, you can get yourself the Lag Captain and Adils combo, which will give you a slightly smaller 120 centimeters across, but an additional 10 centimeters from the monitor. Now let's talk about the hardware. The computer powering this setup, and easily the most expensive addition to this setup, is my 2013 13-inch MacBook Pro. Now, honestly, I don't know if I've just gotten lucky, but this machine is a beast. I won't talk about it too much because this is not the main point of the video, but for a computer as old as this that's gone through hours of video editing on Final Cut Pro, it handles it quite well, and I've been very impressed and really haven't had any need to upgrade my computer for the last 8 years. Now, the one criticism, if I had to have one, and really the only thing that is slightly annoying about using this computer, is the lack of screen real estate, which is why having a monitor has been so good for my productivity. The monitor I have here is the 19.5 inch Samsung S20D300. Although this monitor doesn't have any fancy bells and whistles, for what I need it to do, it's perfect. It gives me an additional screen, the resolution is fine, and it doesn't look too shabby either. Now again, this was bought on the secondary market, and unfortunately, this is the item that's no longer manufactured. I was able to get this for an absolute steal off Facebook Marketplace for only $30. So again, I would recommend you all check out that before buying retail. But if you need an alternative, JB Hi-Fi are offering a newer Samsung model for $239 full price. Now for this, you'll get a slightly larger 23.5 inch display, and arguably its best feature, you'll actually get 19 degrees of curvature. So this is a curved monitor. Now, my brother actually picked up this monitor about a week and a half ago, and it was on sale for $190. And for what he needs, it's been perfect. Now, moving on to the keyboard and mouse, nothing too exciting. I've got the J Bureau's keyboard and mouse combo from Officeworks. Now, this will only set you back $20, and for that, you get a pretty basic keyboard and mouse, but you get a clean, minimal design that does the job. Now, unfortunately, this is actually the only part of the setup that has given me a little bit of grief since using. While the keyboard works perfectly across both Mac and PC, I have had a little bit of trouble with the mouse using it on Macs. Being a wireless mouse, sometimes I'll find it lagging, and after a while that can get quite frustrating. Now let's move on to cable management. As someone who is relatively new to working from home and desk setups, I didn't really think much of cable management. However, after seeing the dramatic difference it does make, it is honestly one of the most important parts when it comes to having a clean, clutter-free setup. As you can see for me, I don't have anything under my desk, and aside from the reason I have extremely long legs, having my cables hidden not only means there's less risk of me yanking things off my desk, but it also means the setup looks much better as well. Now, as you can see for the desk I have at the moment, they actually have a built-in cable management compartment behind each of the drawers. I have a 4-plug extension cord tucked away in there, which powers my monitor and computer charger. The extension cord I have also has 2 USB outlets, which I run through and up the cable hole to be able to charge my phone on my wooden docking station. Now, if your desk doesn't come with built-in cable management, I'll put a link in the description to this alternative you can have, which attaches to flat desks. And finally, we'll talk about accessories. Now, as you can probably tell, there isn't much left to talk about. As you can see, there's only one real accessory I have on my desk, and that's this analog docking station I got as a gift. I was able to find this product on Etsy, and as you can see, it's listed for $80. Now I know some of you are probably like, hey, that completely blows the $100 limit. However, if you really wanted to stick to the rules and having it be only $90, I could always just remove that and keep that side of the desk clear. Now, the next thing, which isn't really an accessory, but I definitely want to mention as part of this video, is the drawer insert I got to fill out these drawers. As you can see, these inserts allow for the drawer to be broken up into 7 boxes that each vary in size. And I found for keeping my drawers clean and making sure that I know where everything is at any one time, these have been such an important addition to this particular desk setup. Now, this product is called the Majella, and again, comes from IKEA. It costs $10. However, I was actually able to get this for free. And the way I was able to do that is because IKEA offer a $10 gift voucher for those who sign up to be part of their reward program, which I believe is called the IKEA family. And basically, while I was sitting in a kitchen, one of their showrooms, I got out my phone, signed up for the program, and no charge. So if you have to go into IKEA because you can't get anything for free off the side of the road or for a huge discount on Facebook Marketplace or Gumtree, make sure that you sign up for IKEA family, get that $10 and have a discount on whatever it is that you need to buy. But other than that, that pretty much wraps up the desk setup. So I hope you guys enjoyed. If you do want to see more of this, go down, click the subscribe button and click that notification bell. And hopefully if you guys enjoyed this content, we'll be posting more in the future. Please check out one of our other videos and I'll see you in the next one.